This grass doesn't look great. Might be time to call my friend Polly the Pollicinid Wasp. She can help with this. This is Polly. She might look a little scary, but Polly's actually a very helpful friend to have in your garden. Polly's a wasp, but she doesn't look much like the wasps you've probably seen before. You know, the ones that look like this, and are always hanging around garbage cans trying to steal sugar. But this mean little stinger is a paper wasp, not a Pollicinid wasp. It's not too hard to tell the difference. For one thing, a paper wasp like this is yellow and black. It's also a lot shorter than a Pollicinid wasp. Oh, and of course a paper wasp like this can be very aggressive and might sting or bite you if you touched it. The one in my hand here is not alive. That's why I can hold it like this, but you should never touch a wasp like this one. A Pollicinid wasp like Polly looks very different. She's shiny black and has an extremely long abdomen. Some people call Polly a scorpion wasp because they think her abdomen looks like a scorpion's tail. But a scorpion like this one isn't even an insect. It's another kind of animal called an arachnid. So scorpion wasp is a silly name for Polly. Polly has the same three body parts as all insects. A head, where her eyes, mouth, and antenna are. A thorax, where her wings and legs are. And an abdomen, where her stomach and hearts are. But you can see that her abdomen is special. It's much longer than most other insects. And it has joints in it so she can fold it and move it in different ways. You can see here that I'm not worried about Polly climbing onto my hand. That's because her long abdomen isn't a stinger. It's for laying her eggs. What are you doing there, Polly?
Who, me? I'm just using my antenna to figure out where to put my eggs. Then I'll push my long tail into the earth and lay an egg there.
You're going to put your eggs under the ground? Why?
Haven't you ever heard of June bugs?
June bugs? You mean those crazy beetles that suddenly appear in June and fly all over the place crashing into lights and people's windows? Of course I've heard of them, but what do they have to do with you putting your eggs under the ground?
Well, June bugs are a kind of beetle, right? And do you know what a beetle is before it's a beetle?
It's a larva, right? Kind of a worm thing that changes into a beetle the same way caterpillars change into butterflies.
Exactly. Now, do you know why the grass outside your apartment building looks so bad? It's because just under the ground there are lots of June bug grubs eating the roots of the grass.
That's interesting. It's a little bit gross, but interesting.
So that's what I'm looking for when I'm hunting in the grass. I'm looking for June bug grubs to lay my eggs on.
Wait, what? You lay your eggs right on the larva?
Yes, one egg on each June bug larva I find.
Why?
Well, now, don't be shocked, but when my babies hatch, they eat the larva.
I see, that's,
See, I knew you'd be shocked. But think about it. If I didn't lay my eggs, you'd have no grass left at all.
Sure. I guess that's true.
Plus, you'd have a lot more adult June bugs in the summer, eating all the leaves off all the trees.
Okay, I'm convinced. Well, thanks for talking with me today, Polly.
If you don't mind, I just need to clean off my ovipositor.
Your what now?
My ovipositor. It's the name for the part of my abdomen that lays the eggs underground.
Sure, be my guest. Well, that's all the time we have for this week on Going Buggy with Uncle Nick. And remember, if you see Polly or her sisters in your garden this summer, just let them do their hunting. She's actually taking care of your lawn.
Looking for grubs in all the wrong places. Looking for grubs.